Authorities caught up with their prime suspect near Binghamton in southern New York State. That's almost 300 miles from the scene of his alleged crime in Dannemora.
Tonight, details on Pavone's capture, his words to the judge when he appeared in court, and the reaction to that from the family of one of the victims. Our team coverage begins with News Channel 5's Heather Van Arsdell.
Well, that's right, Gus. Tony Pavone faced a judge today and a room full of one of the victim's family members. Pavone wept today in court and said something that even surprised the judge.
After an early morning standoff with police, Anthony Tony Pavone was taken to a Clinton County courtroom Friday afternoon to then stand before a judge. Authorities caught up to the 52-year-old late Thursday night after a five-day manhunt, charging him with two counts of second-degree murder. The former corrections officer is accused of killing 43-year-old Patricia Howard and 52-year-old Timothy Carter.
What he's charged with right now, I mean, the maximum sentence he can receive is 25 years to life. If he's convicted, we pursue a elevated charge to murder in first degree and he's convicted of those sentences in New York State are life without parole.
As he did when he first arrived back in Clinton County. Pavone cried when he appeared in court later Friday. He told the judge more than once he didn't want a lawyer. As the judge was about to enter the mandatory not guilty plea on Pavone's behalf, Pavone interrupted him, saying through tears to a stunned courtroom, "I don't need a lawyer, and I'd like to plead guilty to whatever I am charged with." The judge could not accept Pavone's guilty plea at this time. The matter still needs to go to a grand jury. As for police, there are still many unanswered questions. Pavone was found at a motel in Kirkwood, New York, roughly 300 miles south from his Morrisonville home. How he got to Kirkwood and how long he was there is still being investigated. They're also looking into motive.
There's been no discussion that we've been made aware of where he gave any indication where he's been since the incident happened.
Pavone's next court appearance is February 8th. For now, he's being held at the Clinton County Jail without bail. In the newsroom, Heather Van Arsdell, News Channel 5. Back to you.